You see, blessings flow through the fathers. Welcome to today's ZDRX. The prescription is say a blessing. Psalm 107 verse 2. So we want to look at the fullness of blessings. What I call generational blessings. In Genesis 26 verse 13. This was said of Isaac. The man began to prosper and continued prospering until he became very prosperous. Isaac was the only heir of Abraham's blessing and became greater. The blessing did not die with him. You see, blessings flow through the fathers. Isaac had two sons and blessed them, especially Jacob. In Genesis 27:27-29, Isaac blessed him and said, surely the smell of my son is like the smell of a field which the Lord has blessed. Therefore may God give you of the dew of heaven, of the fatness of the earth, and plenty of grain and wine. Let people serve you, and nations bow down to you. Be master over your brethren, and let your mother's sons bow down to you. Cursed be everyone who curses you, and blessed be those who bless you. In Genesis 46:27, and the sons of Joseph who were born to him in Egypt were two persons. All the persons of the house of Jacob who went to Egypt were 70. God even blessed Jacob and became a nation called Israel. Apart from 70 children, he became a nation. In Exodus 12:37, then the children of Israel journeyed from Ramses to Succoth, about 600,000 men on foot, beside children. Look at the blessing. Abraham to Isaac 1, Isaac 2. You know, from Jacob we saw 70. We now see Israel. We now see over 600,000 men on foot beside the children. In Proverbs 13:22, a good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children, but the wealth of the sinner is stored up for the righteous. And I want to close with the story of one evangelist called Jonathan Edwards, an evangelist who devoted his life to serving God. His lineage was traced about 1,394 descendants, and it showed one U.S. vice president, three U.S. senators from these generations, three governors in U.S., three mayors, In U.S., 30 judges, 65 professors, 13 college presidents, 80 public office holders, 100 lawyers, one comptroller of U.S. Treasury, 100 well-known missionaries, preachers, and authors. Not one member of Jonathan Edwards' family was a liability to the U.S. government. What? Can you imagine the fullness of God's blessing in this man's life? You too can say a blessing that will last for many generations to come. Thank you.